Hi, I'm Laura Bottomley. I'm a teaching associate professor of engineering at NC State University. I'm also the director of Women in Engineering and Outreach. Sound in space is an interesting thing because sound waves are pretty interesting things themselves. Sound waves are a way of conveying energy through matter. Sound waves can travel through air. That's what we're used to now. So for sound to travel, there's got to be something to vibrate. Sound can travel through water. It can travel through solids, through walls or something like that. But it can't travel through vacuum, because vacuum, which is what a lot of space is composed of, doesn't have any matter in it. You can't hear sounds in space because they won't travel through that vacuum. So every science fiction movie that has had sounds of explosions, the sounds that ships are making as they go by, have been wrong. And so I do think it's very interesting how The Last Jedi has a very 12 seconds of silence in it. That's how it would be. When a ship exploded, it would appear to be silent because there would be nothing to carry the vibrations of space. They had to put a warning on the door so that people wouldn't think that the audio had gone out. How cool is that? They did something that was actually realistic and they had to warn us about it. So let's talk a little bit about faster than light travel, because Einstein, who worried about these things, told us that it was going to be impossible to ever exceed the speed of light. Star Wars says you have to enter hyperspace in order to be able to go faster than the speed of light. You don't ever actually travel faster than the speed of light because you can't do that, but you enter an alternative reality where points are either closer together or placed somewhat differently. So we'll never be able to travel faster than the speed of light, maybe, but maybe if we learn our geometry in school, we'll be able to achieve it. One of the things that I've always wanted from the Star Wars movies is a lightsaber. So I've actually did a little research to see if I could make one, or to see if we could possibly make one in the future. Well, they don't tell us a lot about what lightsabers are actually composed of. They talk about kyber crystals or something like that. My question was, is it an electrical arc? I mean, electrical arcs can be really hot. We use electrical arcs when we're welding. So I know I could generate one, but the problem is the lightsaber appears to originate at the hilt and then terminate about a meter out. An electrical arc has to have a place to start and a place to end. So a lightsaber can't be an electrical arc. Maybe it could be some other kind of plasma, like, you know, like fire is kind of plasma. It's a fourth state of matter. It could be a plasma. You could confine a plasma with a magnetic field of some sort. But see, right now, all we know about magnetic fields is that they've got to start someplace and terminate someplace too. We don't know how we would make a magnetic field to confine a plasma. Actually, if lightsabers were going to exist and be able to cut through solid metal the way that Qui-Gon's lightsaber cut through solid metal, the amount of energy that it would have, I think I read a calculation someplace that said it would have to be enough energy to power 14,000 homes for the whole time that it was on. Not really practical, so I guess we're going to have to go find kyber crystals and find out what they can actually do, because we don't have the science for that right now.